Hey darling, welcome back to my channel. My name is Omi Odike Nwachukwu and this is Penny White, the channel that God speaks to us. Today, I want to talk to you about how fear holds us back from receiving God's blessings. It will amaze you that a lot of us here, there's this innate fear inside of us that is holding us back from achieving what we want to achieve. And it's funny because we've set out our plans, we have our plans, our goals, our vision here. Inside of our heart, there's something we're afraid of. It could be fear of, I just can't do it. What if I fail? You know, nobody has done it before. There's no blueprint of anyone's life who you've seen done this thing that you want to do. So you just don't know that you will succeed in it. That fear is holding you back. And I want to show you how fear held Moses from receiving a blessing, a huge testimony and a huge miracle that God was going to do in his life. Get ready to just dig inside of your heart. And we're going to bring out the fear together. And we're going to crush the fear never to come up in your life again, and you will achieve all that you have planned to achieve. Holy Spirit, take control, have your way. Let's start discussing. So let's talk about Moses, right? I'll first tell you what happened in Moses' life and how God healed me from a huge insecurity. This insecurity has been holding me back for a long time. It is the insecurity of talking and of stammering. As a young child, I used to be a huge stammerer. Like, so bad that, you know, my family got comfortable, they got comfortable calling me Twister. You know when your family have gotten so comfortable calling you a name that you, like, outsiders used to insult you, but your family got so comfortable. I'll just come home and be like, Twister has come, or Twister, because I used to talk fast, I used to stutter and I used to stammer. It was so difficult to communicate something. It's funny how I'm the person talking to you, I'm talking to you this clear, this fluent. If you had checked me 10 years ago, I wouldn't even have imagined that I'll be able to sit down in front of a camera and talk. I wouldn't have. But wait, let's go back to Moses' story and see how did I get my own testimony from Moses' story. The book of Exodus begins with, you know, Moses being born and how God did this great miracle for his mother. The king of Egypt had given a decree that all male children from the Israelites would be killed, and God saved Moses, really made him find favor. This was baby Moses, who he found favor in the sight of Pharaoh's daughter, brought him in as her son, took care of him and all, yeah. And so Moses grows up, but remember, he's an Israelite and he's living in Egypt. In fact, in Pharaoh's house, he was seeing how the people of Egypt were maltreating his people. And he's been having this gut feeling, yeah, that he's the one that is supposed to rescue the Israelites from the wickedness that the Egyptians are putting on them, you know. So he felt like, you know, well, let me just go and do it. So one day he comes and strikes an Egyptian down. He thought he was doing the Israelites good, though. The next day he comes out, they are mocking him. His own people were mocking him, like, look at this one that killed an Egyptian. So he runs away because Pharaoh heard about it and was going to kill him, right? All this is happening in the book of Exodus chapter 1 and 2, right? Anyway, so Moses runs away, goes to Midian. Yeah, the priest of Midian sees him, likes him, brings him to his family, gives him his child to get married to Zipporah. So Moses is living his life now in Midian. Yeah, then something happened, and this is now where it gets interesting. God wanted to get his attention, and so God comes. Moses goes because he's a shepherd man, you know. So he takes the flocks of the priest of Midian, his father-in-law, and goes to, you know, take care of them, tender them, you know, in the forest or in the bush, you know. And then God wants to get his attention, and then God now makes a bush burn, or lights the bush with fire, but the bush itself is not burning. Moses turns and like, what's happening? So he goes closer to the bush, and God now gets his attention. Now God begins to tell Moses, okay, this is my plan for you. This is what I want you to do. You're going to go back to Pharaoh, and you're going to release the Israelites from Pharaoh. You know, I've heard their cry. And God is giving him like great and huge plans that he has for him. And now he will be like the one that God will use to rescue the Israelites from Pharaoh, right? And the Egyptians. And Moses is scared, and Moses is afraid. I mean, look at it. Some of us might have our own plans, our own goals in life. Oh, this is what I want to do. This is how I want to do it. But deep down in your heart, we're afraid. And Moses gives God all kinds of excuses. Like, first of all, if I go there, if they ask me which God, what will I say? God says, okay, I am that I am. That's who I am. Tell them I am sent you. He says, okay, you know what? So after he finds all kinds of excuses in the world, and God is countering all his excuses, Moses is like, okay, you know what? I can't go because I'm a stammerer. Pause. I want to read that particular one for you, because that was where I got my own healing, because I too was a stammerer. I too was a stutterer. a lot of times I'll be quiet amongst my friends because I just could not talk. If I talk, you make jest of me, you make fun of me, so I was always quiet. Do you get me? So when I found this scripture, I was like, oh my God, listen. And I want you to pay attention to what God replies Moses and how Moses did not see it. So this is Exodus chapter 4 from verse 9. So God gives Moses signs that he's going to give, you know, the Israelites. And God says, if the people do not believe these two signs or pay attention to what you say, you are to take some water from the Nile and pour it on the dry ground, and the water which you take out of the river will turn into blood on the dry ground. So this is the third sign God has given him. First of all, God says, what you have in your hand, a rod, put the rod on the floor, let it turn to snake. God says, put your hand inside your robe, bring it out, your hand is leprous. Like, he gives him all kind of powerful signs. Moses is still scared. And now read verse 10 with me. Verse 10 says, then Moses says to the Lord, please, Lord, I am not a man of words, eloquent and fluent, neither before nor since you've been speaking to your servants, for I am slow of speech and tongue. So Moses is saying, since I've been a child, or even till when you're talking to me right now, God, I don't know how to talk. I'm slow of speech. I'm slow of my tongue. Basically, I'm a stutterer. I'm a stammerer. Listen to verse 11. What did God say? The Lord said to him, who has made man's mouth? Or who has made the mute or the deaf or the seeing or the blind? Is it not I, the Lord? Now then go, and I, even I, will be with your mouth, and will teach you what you shall say. God gives you an assignment. And he's telling God, like, when I cannot go because I'm a stutterer, I'm a stammerer, right? And God is like, wait, chill. Who do you think makes the deaf or the dumb? Who do you think made the blind to see? I'm the one. He now says, go. If you go, I will be with your mouth. 13 now says, but Moses said, please, my Lord, send the message of rescue to Israel by someone else, whomever else you will choose. So God was willing to do his miracle for Moses and help Moses talk. But Moses is still afraid, saying, no, don't send me, send somebody else. The moment I got here, because as a child, I always knew that I would be a speaker. I used to see visions of me speaking, but I didn't understand how I would be a speaker. And I was a huge, like, I was a chronic stammerer. I was like a stutterer. I wasn't just stammering, I was stuttering. I was like, I want to go. I was stuttering heavy. If you had asked little me, I would never have imagined that I Omi or DK will be able to talk to you right now and talk like this and not stutter at all. I would never have imagined it. What is that thing in your life that has been such a stronghold and has held you back for a while? You know what you want to achieve in life, but you just feel like, take for example, you are a single mom and you want God to give you a man that will take care of you, that will love you, that will love your child, that will just be the man that God has made for you. That's your prayer. Every day you put it in your prayer point, I want a man. But you still have that fear deep inside of you that nobody likes single moms. Have all the men finished going for the single girls that you're not come and follow a woman that has a child? See, you're praying for a man, but you are afraid that nobody would get married to you. Little wonder you're not married by now. What are those things in you? God is saying that I'm able to do it. So the moment I found this part, I just said, I stopped too. I said, God, you were going to heal Moses, but he did not see it. He was still shaking. I say, Lord, heal me. God, heal me from stuttering. Help me to speak eloquently. Help me to talk eloquently. When I began my YouTube career, that's when I knew that, okay, God had put something inside of me that I needed to pour into the world. But I was such a stutterer. I don't know if you had seen my videos then, it was very choppy because I was always stuttering in between my lines. So every day as I do is, if I just catch myself, I begin to feel like, oh, this is why I cannot be big, because I stutter. I will go back to that prayer and say, God, you had it in you to heal Moses. If Moses had gone, you'd have healed his speech, but he did not catch it. I've caught it today, God. I will now give him back his word. You are the one that made you deaf, I made you dumb, I made people that can speak. Make me speak. Untying my tongue, losing my tongue. I said this and said this and said it to the point where this is my reality right now. I'm in front of a camera. I'm talking, I'm speaking, I'm not stuttering. There's nothing that is impossible with God. But if you have that fear inside of you and you keep on praying and praying and praying, but deep inside of your heart, you have a fear, the blessings can't come to you. Because there's something in between you. The Bible says that God has not given you the spirit of fear. Instead, he has given you the spirit of boldness, of a sound mind. You have a spirit of power, of sound mind and of love. Why is sound mind necessary? Because think about a mind that is operating in fear. You cannot think soundly. Even if the answer is go, you're scared like, if I go, am I fall? If I go, am I this? The example of single mom I told you, she's afraid. She's outside, but she sees herself like, nobody can like me. But she's praying for a man to come into her life. But she's looking at herself like, nobody can like me. How did you want to like me? Look at single girls there. They can't, you get me? That thing is holding her back. That is why God has said you don't have spirit of fear, but you have a spirit of a sound mind. A mind that is sound can think. Like, there's no limitation to your thinking. You can think. You can say, okay, let's go there. Let's do this. Let's go. Let me put myself there. You put yourself there. You'll be confident. A single mom that has a sound mind, if you see her, when she dresses up, she understands that she has value inside of her. She knows that if a man comes to meet her, the man will see the value inside of her. That is it, a sound mind. You don't have spirit of fear. Let fear not hold you back. And see what fear did to Moses. Let's read. If you go to verse 14, the Bible says, then after Moses told God, man, take somebody else, don't take me. 14 now says, then the anger of the Lord was kindled and burnt against Moses. And he said, is there not your brother Aaron, the Levite? I know that he speaks fluently. Also, he is coming out to meet you. When he sees you, he will be overjoyed. You must speak to him and put the words in his mouth. I will be with your mouth and with his mouth, and I will teach you what you are to say to him. Moses lost a huge miracle that God would have done for him to help him speak fluently because of fear. And that was literally how God says, fine, if you don't have the faith for it, let's use your brother. Call your brother Aaron. He will come and meet you. Tell him my message for you. I will talk to you and you will tell Aaron, and Aaron will tell anybody I send you to. That was how the assignment went. So when they got to Egypt, what happened? God would tell Moses. Moses would tell Aaron. Aaron would tell Pharaoh. But it could have been Moses speaking fluently, but fear held him back. What is holding you back? Ask yourself, that this goal that you want to achieve, what is that fear that is holding you back, that has lied to you that you cannot achieve it? What is that thing? Lay it at God's feet today. Tell God. And Jesus says, in the beginning, it was not so. When God created you, it was not so. That insecurity you have in you, it was not so in the beginning. Circumstances, life has made it happen. And today we lay it at the feet of God. Jesus says, was any plant that my Father in heaven has not planted shall be uprooted. So tell God and say, God, upon my creation, anything that you've not put inside of me, this mentality that is limiting me, I cast it out of my life in Jesus' name. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we give you all glory. We come before you open because you are Father. We lay at your feet everything that is not of you in our lives, oh God. That limiting belief, that mentality, that thing, that insecurity, that thing that is making us feel like we're not worthy to stand before men, that thing that is hiding our glory, that thing that is limiting us from moving, from growing, oh God, we lay at your feet today in the name of Jesus. We pray for our healing today in Jesus' name. Now we say, my Father, take full control of our lives, oh God, and heal us of all our infirmity. Take away insecurity. Take away fear. We rebuke the spirit of fear and we replace it today with the spirit of boldness, with the spirit of power and of love and of a sound mind. We begin to make sound decisions in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, have your way in our lives, oh God. Anything that has ever stopped us from achieving God's plan and purposes for our lives, today, my God, we lay it at your feet today and we come out strong, oh God, and we take the steps that you have planned for us to take with boldness, with confidence, knowing who we are and the God that is backing us up. We know that you have anointed us for this time like this, and nothing shall hold us back in Jesus' name. Thank you, my Father, for healing us mentally, emotionally, spiritually. Any experience we've had in the past that is a stumbling block for us moving and achieving, we lay at your feet, oh God, in Jesus' name. Have your way, oh God. Have preeminence, oh God, in Jesus' name. Amen. And let this prayer not stop here. Whenever you catch yourself thinking like, oh, this is why I cannot achieve what I want to achieve, say, God, this was not how you created me. I take the full form, the full image and likeness of me when you created me. The Bible says, before I formed you, I knew you. The mind that you had of me, my Father, when you were creating me, I take the form right now and I let go of weaknesses and I let go of insecurities and I stand up as a bold child of God, as a confident child of God. I rebuke the spirit of fear. You gotta speak this into your life, no matter what. I told you, God healed me from. I've been talking to you. Yeah, I've stammered once in a while, but like, who would have known? In fact, you can even watch this full video and not even know that I was a chronic stutterer, that my brothers used to call me Twister. Can you imagine? There's nothing impossible for God to do. I promise you, He wants to help you. He wants to walk with you. God wants to walk with you. Don't hold yourself back. Put yourself out there. You are the best version that God has ever created. Nobody can be like you, and nothing can stop you. Yes, that's what God wants you to know today. Don't hold yourself back. Move, go. You're blessed. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have any question for me, if you have any confusion, whatever you want me to help you out with, send me a mail, pennywise1@gmail.com, or just talk to me in the comment section. I want to hear your opinion, your questions, everything in the comment section, my darling. I love you with all my heart. You mean so, so much to me, and God loves you more. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.